Very good morning to all. Good morning.
Good morning, ma'am.
Please revise your portions quickly by the time your friends join. Yes, who's going to give me the definition of banks? Define banking. Yes, who's going to raise your hand? Define banking. What is bank? Give the definition. Definition. Functions of the bank. Yes, Leslie. Nestle, can you try define bank? Yes. Yes, Nestle, give me the answer, please. According to okay, revise fast. Akshay, tell me.
According to Banking Act, Banking Regulations Act 1949, banking means accepting for the purpose of lending. Investment of deposits of money from the public repayable on demand or otherwise.
Okay. Then functions of bank. Akshay. Functions of bank.
Accepting deposit.
Yes. Accepting deposit.
Lending loans.
What type of functions?
Primary
functions, right? Yeah. And how about the secondary functions?
Utility functions and agency functions.
Well, right, very good. Okay, now let's move on to the portions. Okay, so you know what is a bank, the basic model, working model of a bank, how does the bank makes profit, isn't it? Don't you know? Yes or no?
Yeah.
Okay. Then we discuss the functions of the bank. Functions are divided. There are two functions mainly, primary functions and secondary function. Primary function means accepting deposits, lending of loans. Secondary functions are agency function and utility functions. Then we discussed all these. We discussed the history, the evolution of banking. Then other duties of the bank, they keep the records, they give services, financial help, financial aid to the customers, okay. Then the safety measures that they use, history of bank is discussed. Yes or no, aren't you all revising? I think after this chapter, we'll have a test on this chapter, okay. Then what is Reserve Bank of India? What is RBI?
Central Bank of India.
Sorry?
The Central Bank of India.
Central Bank of India is called Reserve Bank. Reserve Bank of India. And what is the function of RBI? What is the duty of Central Bank? Why there is a central bank? Yes, tell me. Will RBI lend loans and do all the basic functions of a bank to the public? Is RBI offering banking functions to the public services? Yes or no? Okay, the test is on Saturday. A written test on the chapter. Okay? By Saturday, whatever portions completed for Saturday, we'll have a small test. Okay? See, RBI is the apex monetary authority. RBI is on the top. RBI controls other banks. RBI doesn't offer banking services to the normal public. RBI controls, regulates, monitors, supervises, manages all other banks in India. Okay, whatever functions the normal banks, the commercial bank provide to the public, okay, all those services are given to the commercial banks by the RBI. Okay, RBI will help the commercial bank in many ways. We'll discuss it soon. And RBI controls the maintains the economic stability. RBI takes several measures to control the inflation. Okay, there are various policies, tools used by RBI. That is about RBI, the Central Bank of India. And who is the governor of RBI? Who is the governor of RBI? Anish?
Ma'am.
Who is our RBI governor?
Shaktikant.
I'm here.
This person. Here, this man. Okay, it's Sri Shaktikant Das. He is the present RBI governor. Okay. Let's move on. And we discussed about commercial banks, isn't it? Types of banks. We were discussing about types of banks, the classification of banks. And we discussed what is commercial banks. Commercial banks means the normal the bank institution, financial institutions that accept deposits, make loan, provide loans, all those banking services, whatever functions of bank we learned, those function services are provided to the public by the commercial banks. And the commercial banks, again we have three types of commercial bank: public sector bank, private sector bank, foreign banks. Okay, let's move on. Public sector banks. What are public sector banks? Public sector banks?
Government.
Yes, Pranav, try. What are public sector banks?
Government.
The major portion, majority of the share is held by the government, the ownership. More than 50% of shares is held by the government of India. Okay, that is public sector bank, the nationalized banks. And we were discussing about state bank and the associates. We finished with that. Now, on 15th February, we were discussing here, there in 1960, the State Bank of India had 7 associate banks. Okay, later on, this date is very important. You should remember this. On 15th February 2017, the Union Cabinet approved the merger of 5 associate banks with SBI. All these banks, all these 7, which were 7, earlier in the beginning, State Bank of Indore and State Bank of Saurashtra, they merged early with State Bank of India. Later on, in 2017, all the other five banks also merged. They came together as one. Now they are functioning as one. There is only one name, that is State Bank of India. Later we had such names, State Bank of Mysore, State Bank of Travancore. They were the associates. But now all these banks are merged together, they became one, and they have only one name, that is State Bank of India. Not only this, there was one more, BMB. BMB, Bharatiya Mahila Bank. There was a bank called Bharatiya Mahila Bank. Okay. That started functioning on 96th birth anniversary of Indira Gandhi. Okay. But due to some reasons, they couldn't succeed in the banking field. So, that was also taken away by State Bank of India. They all joined together. At present, we have 12 government banks in India. That means we have 12 public sector banks in India. Right now, how many? We have 12. State Bank of India, Bank of Baroda, Bank of India, Bank of Maharashtra, Canara Bank, Central Bank of India, Indian Bank, Indian Overseas Bank, Punjab National Bank, UCO Bank, Union Bank of India. These are the public sector banks now. Okay, so what are public sector banks? The ownership, the major ownership vests with Government of India. More than 50% of the shareholdings is done by Government of India. Nationalized banks. Okay. Now we move on to the next category, that is private sector banks. What are private sector banks? Yes. What are private sector banks? Public sector bank means major ownership vests with government. So what are private sector banks?
By some person.
Louder.
By some person.
The ownership lies with a person or a group.
Very good. Right answer. It is with the private parties, private individual. Private sector banks are those banks in which majority of the stake is held by the shareholders of the bank and not by the government. It is not the government, the ownership is with the private parties. Okay, stake means, see, that is shareholding. I'll tell you what is shareholding. See, when a company, we have different companies. I told you, the companies in India are all registered under Companies Act 2013. Okay, now when the companies are in need of money, they want to expand, and if they are in need of money, what they do is they invite the public. Okay, they give chance, opportunity to public to invest in their banks. We'll learn in very detail in coming up classes, but this is just an introduction to you. So companies, when they are in need of fund, they give permission, invitation is given to the public to invest in the company. So I have a company, I am a company, I am in need of money. So I am inviting the public, all of you, to invest. So, and based on the goodwill of the company, what was goodwill? What was goodwill? In the previous class we discussed the term goodwill. Goodwill. From the name itself, you know what is good?
Good products.
Good?
Products.
Sorry, once again?
Good products, ma'am.
No, good name, the reputation. We discussed about Max, Kalyan, the shops you're going to visit. Okay, the reputation, the fame, famous. Okay, anyway, the liking you have towards a business or company, whatever. Okay, So if I'm a well established profit making company, what you do, you all wish to join my company, you will wish to, so you will invest something or the other in my company. Actually I am in need of money, I need fund, okay? So I accept you accept my invitation and you all will invest in my company, and in return of this investment, me, the company, will give you profits. Okay, so it is a benefit to the public, you people, the private individuals also. When you make an investment in the company will give you a share of profit. Okay, and that is called shares, shareholding. So here we are discussing about private sector banks. See, the private sector banks are those banks in which majority of the stake means the ownership, the shares are held by stake is held by the shareholders of the bank and not by the government. Yes, Anish, what's happening? Yes, tell me what is happening. So Anish, explain private sector banks.
Private sector bank, this is owned by private individual or a group of individuals.
Okay, how?
How?
Some person will start the company. Okay, somebody will be there as an owner. Not the government. Anyway, there is no part from of government here. The private individuals are the owners, and again when they are in need of money, they'll invite the public to invest in them. So after all, the conclusion is the ownership is with private individuals only, okay, not the government. Government has no role to do here. So that is private sector banks. Now see, you can see the various private sector banks in the country. They provide, see, the private sector bank is also giving all the financial services, all the functions of a bank, primary functions, secondary functions, all those services are provided by the private sector banks to the public. Okay, only thing is with the ownership. Private sector bank, it is owned by the private parties, and the public sector banks, they are also public. Can invest in the government sector, I mean the public sector banks, but still 50%, more than 50% of the ownership is with government. Okay, that is private sector bank. See, these are the various private sector banks in India, a few of them, not all. Axis Bank, HDFC Bank, ICICI Bank, then Lakshmi, then Rahul Reed.
Axis Bank, CRC Bank, ICICI Bank, Dhanlakshmi Bank, BCB Bank, RBL Bank, South India Bank,
Indus Bank, ING, Vaishya Bank, yes, thank you Rahul, yes Bank, okay, these are all the private sector banks in India, some of them, not all, there are many, some of them, okay. So private sector bank, public sector bank, that's over now. Now let's see the next category, the next type of bank, that is foreign bank, foreign banks. Foreign bank means what? What do you understand by foreign banks? A foreign bank is a type of international bank headquartered in a different country. It is a bank in some other country, not in India. It is a bank from some other country and it is having a branch. It is operating in India also. That is called foreign bank. A foreign bank is a type of international bank headquartered in a different country with branches in India. A foreign bank is obligated to follow the regulations of both the home and host countries. They'll have to follow the rules whatever guidelines are provided by India as well as their home country, whichever country they belong to. Okay, currently as many as 46 foreign banks operating in India as per the RBI as on July 14, 2020. Till then we have 46 foreign banks, and you can see the examples. These are the various foreign banks operating in the country. Who will read? Naveen Jobi, switch on the video, read the names of the bank. Naveen, switch on the video, read please. Naveen is not there. Yes, Naveen. Yes, read.
HSBC Bank.
HSBC.
ANZ. Public Bank.
Public Bank. Shinhan Bank. Okay.
UOB Bank. IMB Bank.
UOB Bank. Anyways, okay, okay. Who was that? Naveen. CIMB Bank, Standard Chartered, Woori Bank. Okay. These are all foreign banks. It's difficult to read the names, the pronunciations. Okay, so you hope you understand what is public sector bank, private sector bank, and foreign banks now. Is it okay?
No.
Okay, now let's see the another category, that is regional rural banks. Regional rural banks. Regional rural banks means they are banks which are set up to provide credit facilities which were to those sections which are backward in the progress, in the growth, backward areas, to bring them into the front, to make them a developed area, to developed section. For that, providing loans to them, that is called regional rural banks. It is set up for providing credit to less fortunate sections of the society. These banks usually operate at regional levels in different states of the country. Okay, different states at different regions they function. Some regional rural banks have branches in urban areas as well. A few of them have offices in the urban area also. Mainly they are with the intention to develop the rural areas. For the development of regional areas, and they have branches in the urban areas also. These are state sponsored regional rural oriented bank. They provide credit for what? Agricultural and rural development. The main aim is to provide credit for agricultural and rural development. See, the main objective of RRB is to develop rural economy. And who are the one who borrow from RRB? What kind of the customers do they have? Their borrowers include small and marginal farmers. We know it is for agricultural as well as rural development. So their customers are farmers, agricultural laborers, artisans, etc. Now, among them, NABARD, NABARD, holds the apex position in the field of agricultural and rural finance. Now, this RRB are jointly owned by Government of India and as well as the region to which it belongs. That is 50% is with the public sector bank, and government of the state at which RRB is situated, 15%. Now the main area, main intention is to serve the rural areas. So in Kerala, we have Kerala Grameen Bank. This is the regional rural bank here. Regional rural banks.
Ma'am, this notes you have sent in the group.
Yes.
This notes you had sent in the group.
I had sent this?
No, I'm asking that you have sent or not.
I can't hear you. Oh, just a second. So in Kerala, this is our regional rural bank, Kerala Grameen Bank, and these are the other RRB banks in India. Okay. There are several RRBs. So what is the main objective of RRB? What for is RRBs there?
To develop rural economy.
To develop? Rural economy. Yes, right. Okay. Now the next one is cooperative banks in India. Cooperative banks. Cooperative banks, from the name it is understood that cooperation. They are organized under the provisions of Cooperative Credit Societies Act of the States. Cooperative basis, that means a few people, they come together, they contribute money and they start an initiative, and it is the main intention is not to make profit but to serve the society, to help the society. That is their main intention. So cooperative banks in India are financial entities established on a cooperative basis. These banks are run by an elected managing committee. There will be a managing committee, and they work on no profit, no loss basis. They are organized and managed on the principle of cooperation and mutual help. So their main intention is not to make profit, but mutual help, cooperation. And their main aim is to promote savings and investment habits among people in the rural parts of the country. Okay. And we have the cooperative banks at three levels. State cooperative bank at the apex level, central cooperative banks at the district level, and primary cooperative bank at the base level. On the top we have state cooperative bank, then comes central cooperative banks, and then comes primary cooperative banks. Okay. So this bank, their intention is not to make profit but mutual help, and their aim is to bring savings and investment habits among people. And see, this is Kerala State Cooperative Bank, and this is a new logo for them, a recently designed one. Okay, Kerala Bank. Next, we see the next category of payment banks in India. The next type of bank, that is payment banks in India. So we discussed what all we discussed till now. So far, what are the types of banks that we discussed?
Public sector bank, private
sector bank. Public sector bank.
Private. sector.
Yes, bank. Private sector banks.
Foreign banks.
Foreign banks.
Regional rural banks.
Regional rural banks.
Cooperative banks.
Cooperative banks. Okay, right. The next type of bank is payment banks in India. Payment banks. What are payment banks? It is a new concept. Something new, recent origin. Payment bank is a new category of banks in Indian banking industry. And it is the RBI who have given this idea. The concept was put forward by RBI. These banks are allowed to operate on a smaller scale without involving any credit risk, without taking so much of risk. They are given instruction to work on a smaller scale. And currently we have 6 payment banks. Do you know what are payment banks? But when you come to know the names of the payment banks, you will recognize. You will understand. I'll show you the names. Yes, have you seen the advertisements? Paytm payment banks, Airtel payment banks. Yes. So these are the 6 payment banks of India. Right now, these are the payment banks that exist in India. But when it began initially, during the initial stage, there were 11. But now we have only 6. Okay, currently there are 6 payment banks operating in India, and initially, the beginning, during the planning time, we had 11. And the guidelines for the establishment of payment banks were issued on 24th November 2014 by RBI. The payment banks will be allowed to open savings account and current account, but they can't issue a credit card. You can get an account, open an account with this bank, but credit facility, credit card is not provided. Okay. According to RBI, almost 60% of people of the country are still not connected with banking sector. Still there are areas, people, major portion of the public are still not aware of this banking facilities. They don't have a bank account. And now you know our government has made so many things through bank only. So due to that reason, several people have bank account now. Majority has got bank account now, but still there are people who doesn't have bank account. And this includes many lower income groups who live in rural areas. People in the rural areas, still they are unaware of all these banking facilities, the banking concept. So the main objective of setting up payment banks are to ensure the financial inclusion, to include so many people, to motivate them to open a bank account, to start bank account, to ensure the financial inclusion by providing payments, remittance services to migrant labor workforce, opening up small savings account of small business holders. Okay, so that is about payment banks in India. To promote the idea, to bring the idea of banking to those who are completely unaware, to include many, to include people to have open bank accounts, to make them learn the banking facilities. It is for that the RBI has put forward such an idea. Okay, please go through your textbook. The types of bank, read. So don't forget, on Saturday I'll give you a small test on this chapter. 15 minutes maximum. Okay? Be ready with a paper, pen on Saturday. Immediately after writing the exam, you will send me the answer script to my WhatsApp number. Okay? So let's see once again till now, what did we discuss so far in this chapter? You know how the business, the banking business is earning the profit. What is a bank? The meaning of bank. Meaning of bank, what is a bank in simple terms? The definition of a bank. Definition, when you give the definition, you should write this, don't forget. If you don't write this, I won't give you marks and it will be just the meaning. It won't be definition. Okay, then definition is there. Then other functions of the bank, the duties of the bank. The besides the basic function, the main functions is definitely the primary functions and secondary functions. Other than that, there are many more functions that the banks perform, the banks do. They are to keep the records. Hope you find all these in your textbook too. To keep the records, to maintain the records of daily financial transactions take place. Now you know, by now you know what is the meaning of financial transaction. Yes. So whatever transactions every day, whatever is taking place, that is recorded. Advise the clients. The clients, the customers approach the banks for various needs. Sometimes the customers are completely unaware. They doesn't have any idea about the services offered by the bank. So the bank will advise them, gather financial information. They'll collect information about the clients. Okay, then coming to the main functions of a bank, primary functions, secondary functions. Secondary functions, we have general utility functions, agency functions. Then other service includes disburse funds. That means we can withdraw funds. You can either deposit fund. This can be done. And for that, security is ensured while withdrawing and depositing. They make sure whether the currency is the original one, it is not the duplicate currencies, black money. Security features are there. All these are made sure by the bank. Then comes history of banking in India. History of banking in India. Understand the history, bring it to very short note. Very important date, the year 2019 marked the 50 years of banking, India's banking nationalization. By 2019, it was 50 years. Don't forget, important date. I think that is not there in the textbook, I don't remember. But this is very important date, a recent date. Then what else? The history is discussed. And the types of banks, commercial bank, regional rural bank. On top we have the RBI. RBI is the apex institution. This one, the RBI controls all other banks in India. RBI is a main bank. Okay. And under RBI we have commercial banks, regional rural banks, cooperative banks. Commercial banks are again classified as public sector banks, private sector banks. This is very, very, very important. Then, public sector banks, we have SBI and its associates. Then other nationalized banks, private sector banks, Indian banks and foreign banks. Indian banks means the banks which belongs to India. Whatever is the private banks started in India itself. Foreign banks means the bank of another country but having a branch in India. Now cooperative banks, I said there are three kinds of cooperative banks. On top we have state cooperative bank, under that comes the central cooperative bank, and under the on the base level we have primary credit facilities. We have one more topic left in this chapter, that is central bank, about central bank. The functions of central bank, we'll discuss it in the next class.